Thank you, Mr. Chairman. As I sit and listen to this debate today, no doubt the Democrats' position is let's just keep the status quo. Don't change anything. Let's continue on with our $17 trillion debt. Let's continue to borrow and spend and borrow and never change course. And we know that's their position by way of the amendments they offered in Budget Committee, by the conversation here on the floor today. And Mr. Speaker, we know that by way of the Senate budget when they put one out, because it never balances. And we know that because of the President's budget that he puts out, it never balances. It passes off this massive liability to the next generation. And their policies have a real impact on the country as a whole. Listen, we talk about seniors. The Medicare Trust Fund is going broke in 12 years. It's going bankrupt. And my friends across the aisle, Mr. Speaker, they don't want to change it. They want to leave our seniors today and our future seniors today in jeopardy with a trust fund that's going broke. And it's hard to lead. It's hard to put ideas on the table to say, listen, my friends, let's come together. Let's be responsible. Let's make it sustainable. Let's fix it. And the response is, don't do a darn thing. Continue on the course to a bankrupt trust fund. That doesn't serve our seniors well. That doesn't serve our next generation of seniors well. And speaking of Medicare, there is only one party in this town that took over $700 billion out of Medicare and used it for Obamacare. They raided it, and that's the Democrat Party, Mr. Speaker. That's unacceptable. And to come to the floor today and tell us and the American people that they're here to protect it just isn't true. Listen, we're on the course to a fiscal calamity. And if that happens, who are the people who are hurt the most among us? The people who are hurt the worst are the poorest, the ones who are most in need of government assistance. Now I think, listen, we should look to our churches and our communities for that help, but there is a role for government. And if you have a debt crisis, if you have a fiscal crisis, and you have people who have a hard time heating their homes or putting food on their table, or kids that want to go to college, or you want to build roads and bridges, there's not money there for those projects. If you want to be able to invest in your future, you have to make sure you have a budget that's sustainable. When you pay $230 billion in interest alone today, when the Fed is printing money to buy down that interest rate, the President says in 10 years, interest on the debt is going to be $880 billion. You can build a lot of roads, bridges, you can feed a lot of people, you can send a lot of kids to school for almost $1 trillion a year. Let's fix this problem, let's work together, let's balance our budget, and it starts right here in the House in the Budget Committee. I yield back. The time is-